Thank you so much for joining this behind the scenes chat with the executive producer and producers of the new CNN original series, Patagonia, which premieres on CNN on Sunday, July 10th. Now, there are going to be 6 episodes airing on CNN. And right now we're taking you, the viewers, behind the scenes for how this amazing project came together. So thank you all for joining for this conversation. James Smith, the executive producer of the series, I want to start with you. Why don't you set the scene for everyone? What is the series all about? And what should people expect the experience to be when they do tune in?
Right. Yeah. Well, what's the series about? It's about one of the wildest and most beautiful and most dramatic parts of the earth, Patagonia, and the wildlife and people that live there. And we're really trying to experience the world through the eyes of the animal, through the eyes of the gauchos, the sheep herders, through the eyes of the fishermen, the people who live in the forest, people who live very close to nature. So I think first and foremost, it's a celebration, and viewers can be expected to be transported into this amazing world of beauty and drama, and, you know, and live this world through extraordinary animal and human characters. But it's also, I think, you know, it's an important kind of reality check on some of the challenges facing wildlife and people in this wild part of the world too. So I think a lot of wildlife series portray a rather idealized and perfect view of the world where everything is fine. You know, we represent, as true to kind of CNN, I think, and the fantastic news channel that CNN is, we present the reality. So we do reflect things like climate change, things like fishing and salmon farming, and some of the other things that are threatening the natural world. But I think first and foremost, it's an extraordinary adventure into this beautiful part of the world. And with, you know, the team here, I could talk for a long time about how beautiful it is, but I didn't get the opportunity to go out there. So Rene, Kate, and Kevin shot, you know, and directed more than 80%, I would say, of all of our stories. And they were the ones that experienced it and managed to get, I think, really, really beautiful footage. I think that's what really sets the series apart from others, is the photography, the cinematography is just extraordinary. And it's a credit to, you know, my brilliant team for getting such amazing footage.
And I do want to dive into that and what the experience was like actually shooting this. I watched the first episode. I'm telling you, it was amazing. It was an amazing look to see these animals, the wildlife, the nature as never seen before, and just seeing how they survive and thrive in this unexplored region of South America. So I want to talk to you all about what it was like to actually shoot this. I understand that you shot this series over a period of a year. Again, as we mentioned, this is a very unexplored, untouched section of the earth. And I just kind of want to get a sense of what sort of conditions did you all endure to capture some of these very intense moments, some of them with the wildlife. Rene, I want to start with you. This is a region you're very familiar with. What was one of the most memorable moments while shooting here?
I think for the whole crew, there's a couple of very special things about this project. We all come from the wildlife filmmaking industry in which our stories are from animals, right? But in this case, it's the human aspects and the human angles and the life from humans coexistence with the animals. And every story that we film, no matter how many times we film that a specific animal, because, you know, there's pumas, there's whales in there, but we're adding this other element, which is people. And I think that that makes every shoot special, every shoot different. And for all of us, also the fact of having COVID and restrictions and a lot of problems for production from that side of things made everything not only harder, but also much more special. And it's really hard to pick the stories. And probably for Kay, for Kevin, for James, that James was constantly on the sat phone listening to all of our dramas in the middle of nowhere. But for all of us, it's really hard to pick one because every story was very unique and very special. And no matter how many you know, how many times we filmed pumas before. This is different, and it feels different from every aspect.
Yeah, I mean, who was it that had a face-to-face confrontation with a puma? I want to hear all about that, and I want to hear how you kind of got out of that jam. So please share that story.
That was me.
Oh, great.
But that was me. But, you know, it's a close encounter, and it's a cat that is getting close to us, to the film crew. But this is a story about coexistence. The reason why that puma got close to us, it's not because he sees us as food or a threat or anything. He was actually walking around looking for guanacos, the main prey. And in this specific place, and I think the story that you'll be able to watch the audience on the CNN series is about pumas in a place where they're not threatened. And this is a story of evolution of people protecting them, which actually takes you to an encounter like this, in which the cat was going through, we are in there, the cat gets close to us. Obviously, we know what to do. We've been filming those cats for almost a decade in that specific place, but they don't see us as a threat. They don't see us as prey. It's a place where balances are being, you know, taken care of people. So that's why it's not a real potential threat for us. We always, you know, you have to keep calm and just stay still. Don't move, don't run, don't turn around. It's an animal, potentially can kill you, but that animal wasn't on the mood of attacking anyone. It was just going through. And I think that talks very nicely about Patagonia, because those encounters can only happen here, not only with a puma. Kevin can talk about whales. Kate also about so many different species when she was traveling on a really cool adventure on a vessel for almost a month, right? So that's Patagonia, animals that they don't see people as a threat, because it's very isolated and because coexistence is happening.
Yeah.
I think I just need to jump in there because Rene, you know, Rene's been very cool about it. But I mean, when you see the scene, it is extraordinary. I mean, that puma, your viewers will know it as a cougar. You know, it's a huge cat. He's downplaying it, but he was extraordinarily relaxed. And I think it's a testament to the skill of all of our team, not just Rene, but the other camera operators and who were mostly almost entirely from Chile and Argentina, that they knew what to do in those situations. And you make a mistake, someone starts running, that puma will start chasing you and it could get bad. But, you know, Rene, you've been very cool about it, but it's an extraordinary scene when you're in our behind the scenes episode.
Yeah, and I mean, just for people to keep that in mind as they're watching, that this was not an easy task to pull off. I mean, you're out there in the wild and trying to capture these natural encounters and moments amongst the wildlife, and you find yourself face to face sometimes with the wildlife. I mean, everything from the killer whales to the squid to the pumas. I want to find out a little bit more about just how hard was it to capture these moments of these animals encountering each other. I mean, there's a penguin fight that you guys have in the first series, and it's just amazing to see these sort of encounters between the animals themselves, the killer whales, that encounter with the seals, like all of this. And I'm not, no spoilers, but people will see it once they tune in. But how difficult was it to capture these moments?
I think Kate would be good to answer this one. So in our second episode, the main focus were blue whales. And well, Kate, you pick up the story, but just how easy is it to find the world's largest animal?
Well, you'd think finding the largest animal that's ever lived would be easy. So we had a team of experts that flew in to help us on our mission. We had an incredible boat crew that knew the waters where we were sailing. We had all eyes on deck, and we spent 11 days sailing up and down this area where the blue whales come to feed every summer. And we found nothing. And for the first 6 days, we tuned into all the skippers. So that was a great way of finding out what was going on in the area, and that was to tune into the local people. And our captain informed us that no one had even seen a blow or any whale in 5 weeks. So we were then faced with this decision, you know, do we keep going? Do we keep searching? Or do we make a call to move on? But we stuck it out, and we made a few a few other decisions, I sent up a spotter plane into the air to have a look for us. And luck paid off literally at the on the 11th hour. And we found a whale on the last day. And fortunately, with natural history, a lot can happen in just a few hours. So, yeah, we managed to tell the story. But it was, yeah, it was very tense. So your answer to your question really is, obviously, you need a great team in place and you need a lot of preparation and you need the right gear and you need, yeah, you need the right people, but you also need a lot of luck. And I think we had a lot of luck on this series.
So, Kevin, we haven't heard from you yet. I want you to kind of lift the curtain for us and just tell me, what was it like filming in such a remote area? And waiting for these encounters, what is it like working on a project like this?
Yeah, thank you. Spending an entire year on the film, it's something amazing. So you will see maybe 40, 50 minutes of a chapter that was shot on an entire year. So we spend days and nights and storms and, you know, rainy days, beautiful days, and all that is like just put together for a movie. But being around these whales, this orca, these elephant seals, the penguins, as you say, the penguin fights doesn't happen every day or every moment, but if you're there living with them, you start to understand them, you start to know them very well. And I feel very privileged to work on this series because I was able to share with these animals, these amazing animals, all their stories.
Yeah, I'm curious how this experience, like what you all learned from it. I mean, was there anything that surprised you or anything that you walked away from this project learning that you didn't know before? Anyone can jump in on that.
I'll say just one thing. It's how important working with local people is. You know, we it was COVID, which obviously meant we had huge restrictions with getting people from outside of Patagonia into the country. We couldn't send anyone into Argentina. So had it not been for local crews, local talent, people like Ren, you know, working for us and getting access to wildlife, to locations, to stories, we would never have been able to make this show. So I think one of the silver linings out of COVID is that it's really emphasized how important working with local people is.
I agree. And it was something CNN, you know, obviously we've got executive producers at CNN, and from the start they said, you know, they wanted this to reflect the realities of life in this extraordinary part of the world. So they wanted the engagement from the start of, you know, local filmmakers. So we, you know, Rene was the first person I called, you know, when this project was getting started. You know, we quickly you know, heard about Kevin and signed him up, and, you know, got him on the team for more than a year. But Kate's absolutely right. And I think working with people who know the landscape and the wildlife and the local characters better than anyone else gave us a really deep insight. You know, it gave us access to places we wouldn't have got to film in, you know, and it gave us insights that we would never have got before. So I think you're absolutely right, Kate. And that is a really key part of this series. I think it has that local authenticity and expertise that comes throughout.
Yeah, I'm thinking about that one scene with Lucas, the scuba diver, who is diving and all of a sudden gets a visitor. And without giving too much away, I just wondered, you know, was that again just a moment of luck? And how does one get that shot? And what was the thought? Like, were you all freaking out at this point when you come into such close proximity with such a monstrous, you know, animal? I'm just wondering that specific moment.
Yeah, yes, so
Kevin, I mean,
Peninsula Valdez. So Peninsula, so Lucas del Rio is my neighbor. We live very close to each other. He lives fishing on the coast. He spends every single day of his life in the water with the whales. So for him, whales are like kind of cows or sheep, maybe for people from England or United States. These are very common. Whales come to Peninsula Valdez in thousands. Like, there are like almost 1,500 whales coming each year to Peninsula Valdez, and they are all around us. So we are very used to them. But even if we are used to them, we still like get surprised every single time we go into the water. Like for this series, we filmed for the first time killer whales attacking whales, and we also filmed for the first time ever a mother whale nursing the baby, giving milk to a baby. That's a very, very intimate moment that was never seen before, never filmed by a film crew before. And we get that. Even if we live there for a lot of years, that was the first time we saw it. So that's also why this series is so important.
Yeah, and that kind of leads me to my next question. I mean, why did you all feel like this was such an important series to shoot and share with the world? And what do you hope the impact is?
I think these are the stories that I'm talking about myself, the teams that I work here in Chile, and probably Kevin will feel the same, and Kate and James will support this, is that there's so many stories that we've been for years trying to show, trying to tell, trying to film. And this series gave the opportunity of going there, trying those stories and making them work as a nice storytelling for the rest of the world. I was mentioning before the human aspect, the human side of these stories, they bring so much to every animal story. And I think those are the stories that the world needs to see, the relation of humans and animals, positive relations. Some of them are not working that great. What are those solutions? And I think that's what this series is bringing to everyone. There's stories that needed to be told to everyone.
And James?
I agree. No, Rene, you said it very eloquently. I think it's a really unique series, this. There's a lot of wildlife projects out there on all sorts of different channels. But this feels different, and it's very powerful, I think, as Rene says, that we, from the start, we CNN said, whatever stories, you know, whatever the best stories are, tell them. They weren't saying, oh, well, don't film that. If there's something about climate change, avoid that. And you do get that sometimes on other projects. We had total free rein, which I think for all of us as filmmakers was very liberating. And largely, as I said at the start, it's a celebration, but being able to look at the threats to blue whales. And blue whales are just truly magnificent. This is another story that Kate looked after, but we were able to realize that the blue whales come to the south of Patagonia, but also there's lots of threats to them, including ships, you know, that move around. It's a very busy shipping channel, and the blue whales are in danger, and the scientist that we filmed with is trying to protect them. So I think we're able to tell stories with real power as well as real beauty. And that was really liberating. And I think that's hopefully, you know, the message that will come through on the series. It's, you know, I think it's salt propellers, you know, and a really enjoyable watch.
Mm-hmm. Yes, also Patagonia is a place.
Yeah.
It's a very remote place with full of great and wild and very kind of far away animals. But also it's a very fragile place, you know. We show the threat of these animals they are living, but also there are a few stories that bring us a lot of hope. We show how the whales are recovering after years and years of chasing them. So I think for the first time I see on a series and a movie a story about how these whales are doing great. So now after like 50 years of protecting them, they're finally coming back to the coast of Argentina, and in great numbers. Like there are, each year we are having more and more whales that are going to also new places we never see them before going. So it's not only about the threats that are very present in other series also, but here it's also about hope. Poppy, the scientist who studies penguins, he saw, I think for the first time, a penguin colony growing up from zero. He saw the first six penguins nesting in this place. He cleaned up the beach, he protected the entire place. And after 10 years, there are thousands of penguins living on these beaches. So there are also great examples of how the power that we have. If we do something to protect the wildlife and the places, the animals will recover and be here again in great numbers.
That's such a good point. And Kate, I'm just wondering, do you agree? I mean, will this series serve as sort of a rallying cry to people who watch about the power that we do have to kind of address the threats that you all have identified for the wildlife, for these environments? Is that the ultimate hope for the impact of this series?
Absolutely. And the characters themselves, I mean, with every story, you feel their passion and their dedication, and that's what will engage the audience. And they're prime examples of people out there who are making a change and how we can make a change. So yeah, absolutely. It will. We really hope that it will encourage people to make different choices, make the right choices, but it will also, yes, bring a lot of hope.
Yeah, and I mean, with you guys were shooting this for, you said over the course of a year, obviously you've been in this world of nature and filming wildlife for quite a long time in your career, but I'm just curious, despite your expertise, was there anything about the animals, about the wildlife, about the environment that you were filming in that you all learned that you didn't know before?
Patagonia. It's the worst, one of the worst weathers. Some of the places where we were around is unpredictable. You can't go on your phone. It's not going to tell you what's going to happen tomorrow. And some of the shoots that were very weather dependent. And this is wildlife filmmaking too, which there's the other challenge, seasons. Animals and the stories that we get to film and bird nesting, that's a very specific thing on a very specific time of the year. And most of the things that we were filming were very specific on certain time of the year. But you could go on a week and things were not happening. What happened to Kate, for instance? So that's a challenge. And I think this series, I don't know what you think, Kate, after sailing and looking for the blue whales, that's only one of the many challenges of things, right? But we were very reactive and we had the support. And this was great from the point of view of, you know, all the team from James at the main offices and CNN. We were very reactive. We got some stories that were not planned before. We were able to react in a matter of days to get some things that were happening. And we were able to improvise because, you know, stories are very seasonable. They're very organized in a time of a year, but what if they fail? We needed to find more stuff. So reactive.
Yeah. And you talked a little bit about weather. I mean, I'm just curious, how bad did it get? What was the most extreme condition that you had to withstand while filming all of this? Kate?
I actually lucked out. I was in the northern part of Patagonia in Chile during the summer. So I was lucky that I didn't experience any real, really bad storms. I think Rene had the worst of it.
Ah, okay. So what was that like? Just give us a descriptor of like just how bad the conditions were so we know what you went through while we're watching the series.
I think the worst was Tessa, right, James? Tessa and Ignacio, that they were waiting to get a helicopter ride and they were waiting like for what, for a week?
For 8 days in storms. Yeah, that was, but I think you were out at sea, that scene where there's some people, you know, not coping with the waves, rough weather, you were, you know.
There's some very good in the behind the scenes episode where you'll see Rene experience four seasons in a day.
Oh wow! Okay.
What about that? Yeah, we were basically we went to check for a nesting site of a black browed albatross that no one has ever seen, no one has ever filmed, and we were with an ornithologist that read a paper from I don't know how long ago that it mentioned that this was a nesting site. These birds, they nest on islands that are far away from land. So weather is worse down there in the far south. And yeah, we had horrible weather. I think from 80% of the crew were vomiting. And we still had to fly the drone, the usual stuff. But safety first, we were never at risk, really. But people was not great, I would say. And we were calling James, of course, on sat phone later. Like we couldn't achieve what we wanted. We couldn't go to the island, basically. Because of weather, but we still managed to put the drone up just to check what was going on. Things like that, they happen all the time. Safety first.
Okay. Yes. Well, this was amazing. I mean, I have to say it was riveting to watch these encounters from the killer whales to, you know, to the penguins, to the seals. I mean, you all had incredible luck out there to capture these moments. And I just, for people like myself, and I think many of our viewers will really appreciate the way you lift the curtain, lift the veil, so that we have a better understanding of what is happening in this very unexplored section of South America, Patagonia. So thank you all for your hard work, for facing off against a puma, to bring these wonderful stories to us. And again, if you're watching, this is an amazing series. You do not want to miss. It premieres on CNN on Sunday, July 10th, 6 episodes, and it is visually stunning. So kudos to all of you for your work and bringing this story to all of our viewers. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Yes.